estrogen and meat, dairy and eggs. Here's the proof that you've been waiting for. Here's the conclusive understanding of why men are at such great risk, not only to have coronary heart disease, high blood pressure due to the thickening of the arteries, increased risk of diabetes, increased rate of cancer, and now we know conclusively increased rate of prostate enlargement, of ED, erectile dysfunction. I'm going to say that estrogen dominance is probably one of the biggest factors that faces our nation today due to not only disability, but the increased death rate associated with estrogen dominance. And is it the estrogen dominance or is it the cholesterol within the foods? It's kind of both. But let's get into this. I think you're going to find this, quite revealing here as we proceed to estrogen in meat, dairy, and eggs with Dr. Michael Greger. Here we go.
Recent observed feminization of aquatic animals has raised concerns about estrogenic compounds in water supplies and the potential for these chemicals to reach drinking water. While much attention has been focused on the environmental impacts of xenoestrogens, the endocrine-disrupting industrial pollutants, relatively little research has examined the ecological consequences of environmental loading with actual estrogens.
Okay, so he's saying that the water contains what's called xenoestrogens from chemicals, plastics, even cash receipts. We'll delve further into that. But here's where the bomb is going to be dropped now, and that is this very potent form of estradiol, which actually the biggest source you're going to learn right now is meat, eggs, dairy product, chicken, and fish. Here we go.
This is somewhat surprising, given that the potency of some estrogens can be thousands of times more estrogenic than typical endocrine-disrupting chemicals. Estradiol, for example, is at least 10,000 times more potent than most xenoestrogens, and dietary exposure to natural sex steroids in meat, dairy, and eggs is therefore highly relevant in the discussion of the impact of estrogens on human development and health.
Okay, I want you to really focus in on what he's saying, that these estrogens naturally present in animal products, not just those that are hormonally treated. I mean, even if they're organically raised, the animal products, by their very nature, have menstrual cycles. So they're loaded with toxic estrogens. And these estrogens are nearly, as he stated, 10,000 times more potent than the most common environmental xenoestrogens. In other words, people are so worried about drinking their water from plastic bottles, and I agree, switch to glass, not plastic. They're worried about exposures from fire retardants in the bedroom and so forth. I agree. They're worried about pesticide chemicals loaded with estrogen toxins, and again, I agree. But he's saying that the number one cause of estrogen dominance is shocking to hear this. Is animal product and related dairy. Oh my gosh. And we're talking that inclusive of chicken, and because fish is loaded with PCBs from toxins in the ocean, and it concentrates in a process of what's called biomagnification. When little fish are eaten by bigger and bigger fish, the bigger the fish you eat, like tuna or swordfish, the more estrogen dominance you're going to be exposed to. So let's go into this. This is serious.
And like, chicken estrogen is identical to human estrogen. They're identical molecules, so it doesn't matter if it ends up in our drinking supply from women taking birth control pills excreting it in their urine or cows excreting it into their milk.
Okay, so he's saying now that it doesn't matter if the estrogen's coming from birth control pills that spill off into the water, runoff, and so forth. These estrogen toxins are really more coming from milk excreted from cows, and they're so toxic that it's causing rampant disorders. And it's interesting that for example, this one sentence, the child's exposure to total estrogens from drinking water, prescribed and naturally occurring, is about 150 times lower than the exposure from consuming milk directly. So milk is a seriously dangerous source of estrogen. In fact, I remember a Harvard study showing that it was 30 times more estrogen sulfate in milk or yogurt or cheese than it is in just consuming fluids of such as water, which water, unless it's purified, can have some of these xenoestrogen toxins. So let's delve deeper here in what's going on. This is very serious.
The source doesn't matter, the quantity does. And a child's exposure to estrogens in drinking water is about 150 times lower than exposure from cow's milk. So our day-to-day estrogen levels are more likely determined by whether or not we happen to eat dairy products that day. Human urine is often cited as the main source of natural and synthetic estrogen.
Okay, so he's saying a piece of cheese or a glass of milk or a cup of yogurt is going to expose you to 150 times more estrogen than most other causes. This is why those who are health-oriented know why I've been advocating for 40 years to be dairy-free. Are dairy alternatives better? Yes. Almond milk, cashew milk, even soy milk. And I'm not a big fan of soy milk, but if you do, ideally try and get it GMO-free, organic. But everyone's blamed the soy when the reality is it's the animals that are causing all the toxins. Now we're going a little bit further into the toxic environments. The human urine is often cited as a source of natural and synthetic estrogens. I guess run off into the ocean. Okay, hold on. Let's see what it says.
Estrogens in the aquatic environment, but the level of estrogen, even in the urine of heavy meat eaters who have significantly higher levels, pales in comparison to the estrogens excreted by the farm animals themselves. Pigs, sheep, cattle, chickens produce literally tons of estrogen every year. Women may excrete 16 micrograms every day, but farm animals may release 10 times more. In the case of pregnant cows, thousands of times more.
Okay, so I hope you're paying attention to this, because they're saying that a menstruating woman releases in her urine something like 16 micrograms. However, a pregnant cow can literally release thousands of times more estrogen into the general environment. So we're comparing something like 15 to 30 micrograms excreted in the feces of the animal, the livestock. However, the total estrogens from cattle that are pregnant can be upward to 111,620 micrograms of exposure of estrogen. So we're not immune, not just cattle, pigs, sheep, and all these animals we raise, and then all their feces and urine gets into the water runoff, into the water tables. And this is leading to the biggest, I'm predicting now, and that's why I'm writing the book, it's coming out soon, the biggest source of harmful toxins that interfere with your hormonal balance. It's all dependent on what you eat. This is why I wrote the book, Simply Healthy Cookbook, which is dairy-free, gluten-free, oil-free, and whole plant-based foods. I wrote the book originally, Grow Young and Slim, back in the early year 2000. I wrote the book, How to Look Great and Feel Sexy, in 1994. And I've been talking about this, but now the science is in. There is no argument or dispute. The science is in. And when you look under a blood sample, and by the way, this is a picture of a drop of my blood in the middle of the day. My blood stays so pure by eating plant-based whole foods throughout the day. It doesn't accumulate excess fat. Now, the fat thickens the blood and sticks it together, and also excess fat leads to higher prolactin levels, which increases the risk of prostate, that is, of breast cancer in women. Excess fats also do associate to a higher risk of other forms of cancer. But what you can't see in this blood drop is what's called excess cholesterol, which we have to use a different machine to measure the concentrations, because the cholesterol is dissolved in the blood and you can't visually see it so well. So that being said, the cholesterol that we see present here is of major concern to all of us. All of us have to be aware. So I'm not out here crying wolf. I'm trying to explain to you the dangerous toxic side effects. And I want you to really listen to this part. This is the scientific factors that everyone's ignoring, the public, the legislators, the marketers, all those people promoting keto. I mean, this is important, really important stuff. So let's jump back in here.
Animal waste may contribute an estimated 90% of total estrogens in the environment. 5 gallons of runoff water contaminated with chicken manure may contain a birth control pill's worth of estrogen.
Oh, there it is. So he's saying that the amount of runoff from these chickens alone really contributes 90% of the total estrogens in our environment. That means that this runoff is like equivalent to men taking a birth control pill every day when you eat the poultry or you get exposed in the water supply or mixed into the general food supply. These estrogens are toxic. Imagine why so many men have become feminized. I don't mean to be rude, but I go to the beach and it's even affecting young people, and it's terrible that they're forming man boobs. They're becoming obese, and women, excess estrogen is not good, not excess of this type. These women are having symptoms that also increase obesity risk and problems with fibroids and so forth. So again, all this excess estrogen from animal product is toxic, it's horrible, and has to be removed from the environment.
Estrogen levels in poultry litter are so high that when farmers feed chicken manure to their animals to save on feed costs, it may trigger premature development. Poultry manure has been among the highest hormone content, quadruple the total estrogens, and 9 times more of the 17 beta estradiol, the most potent estrogen, which could be considered a complete carcinogen as it exerts both tumor-initiating and tumor-promoting effect.
Okay, so he's saying that the poultry manure is oftentimes even more concentrated than the cow's manure in these beta estradiol, which are the most potent, dangerous, in fact, completely carcinogenic. When exposed, tumor initiation and tumor promotions occur. Wow. All you men eating chicken during the coming up Super Bowl, probably what, hot wings, and now you're drinking beer with it? I'm going to talk about beer during the course of this discussion about estrogen dominance as well, but let's get to the source. At least go to plant-based wings. I think they'll come out soon. I go to Yard House and I get some plant-based wings, and they have some tasty Frank's wing sauce, and I love to eat them. I don't eat them often because they're a little bit fried. They have a little more oil than I normally would eat. But in all my cooking, I prepare foods, plant-based whole foods, because I love being a man. And estrogen is toxic, and it makes you feminized. It makes you emotional. It makes you overweight, at risk for cancer and prostate cancer. I hope I'm not really belaboring this, but this is the truth, and let's face the truth as it is. Let's go on.
Thanks. You know, but who cares, though? From a human health standpoint, do we care about feminized fish or the appearance of intersex cockroaches? The problem is that the hormone...
Okay, so not only are humans being exposed to toxins, insects, even roaches, are becoming intersex. I guess they're male-female mixed. The fish are having trouble being able to replicate or multiply. But the food supply for humans? Horribly toxic now.
Hormones get into our food supply. Endogenous steroid hormones in food of animal origin are unavoidable, as they occur naturally in these products. It's not a matter of injected hormones, which are banned in places like Europe in order to protect consumers' health. They're part of animal metabolism, and so as a matter of fact, you know, all foodstuffs of animal origin contain steroid hormones, and the presence of hormones in food has been connected with several human health problems.
Wow. I hope you replay this segment, because we know that many health problems are now associated with the toxic estrogens from an animal-based diet. So these guys out there advocating a carnivorous-based diet, there's a doctor out there that I'm going to reply to soon. He keeps bragging that he never has to take hormones because, you know, he eats so much meat and he's a carnivore.